day four of Permission Week. We were going hard all week.
All week. And this tonight, my God.
It's only getting hotter.
It's getting hotter. Okay. The woman is coming in on fire. All right. PJ is preaching a word and Pastor Tasha is also singing.
Yeah. I'm so excited for y'all to experience. Like, it was a night like no other. So go ahead, share this stream with a friend because they don't want to miss tonight's word.
Yeah. It's going to be amazing. Can't wait to see or rewatch what the Lord has done through this whole situation. So let's go ahead, jump in through prayer. Take us in, Janaya.
All right. Mm-hmm. God, so excited for what you're about to do tonight, Lord. We are so in expectation for this word, this worship, God. Would you speak to us a fresh word? Would you do something in us that you've never done before, God? Our hearts are open and we're so ready, Father. Do what only you can do. We love you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Let's worship.
Anybody thankful to worship a God who holds it all together? Our past, our future, our present is in His hands. Come on.
The right time when I least expect it. just got a download from Holy Spirit. He said, tell them this is voice activated. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, if you don't help me praise God for what I'm about to tell you, leave me alone forever. Say, neighbor, the reason the enemy couldn't kill me is because my story is not finished. I need you to shout, I've never seen. I need you to shout, cause where you put a period, swapped it out for a comma. What's your story? What's your story? You don't know like I know what is done for me. Loose my shackle. Let's have permission. We say, say, I've never seen. Song the other day, and I didn't know what to do with it. We'll talk later. But he said, we Neon said, we were right. He said, for God is the one who gives seed to the farmer. Give me bread to eat in the same way. He will provide for me. I've never seen the rise. Forsaken. No, I see it. Begging for bread. He gives seed to the farmer, bread to eat in the same way. He will provide for me, cause increase is all around me.
Seconds to pray, don't like you're not waiting to see it with your eyes, cause you already see it in your heart. Increases on me everywhere I look, everywhere I go. We done messed up the whole set. We gotta get out, we gotta get out. Do tonight, late in the midnight. tell them, get ready for more. Get ready. You heard the preacher today, Orion, to prophesy to you. It's just stress marks. He's just expanding you. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready.
Ladies, as you know, moments like this can sometimes seem like they're only about one. You could almost think that this moment was only for you to be invited into a place to say oohs and ahs and what an amazing service. What I want you to know is from the very, very beginning, the moment he spoke the word permission, he saw every single woman in this room. He's Alpha and Omega and
everything in the middle. I'm just a young country girl from Sandersville, Georgia, small town. But what I've learned and what I pray that every woman has received in this room, it only takes a small yes. What God does with a small yes is he picks it up. He breaks it. He blesses it. And he multiplies it. Do you see a room full of multiplication? What gets better is it doesn't stop with what's in this room. There are women in Africa that have signed up to be a part of the banner of permission. There are women in the Ukraine. I'm not talking about something that I'm projecting for future. There were women that signed up from there. Her name is Nana. Her name is Pam. Women, some that I've never seen their real faces, but I've connected with them in their hearts. I hail true to the thing that the Father said in the beginning. If you'll give me a yes, if you'll do your part, I'll do mine. Do I have any other women in this room that is desperate to give a yes? In a moment like this, you can say, oh, this is so pretty and it looks so good. Beyond what it looks like, it is powerful. Powerful to change lives. Powerful to heal broken women. Powerful to see people that felt unseen. Do y'all mind if I just take a moment to show you the face of some women that have been changed by the banner of permission? Can I have every permission coach to join me right in front? I want to show you how this all began. Every permission coach, these are the women right here that have locked arms with me and said, if you carry it, I will hold your arms up. See, you might have thought that this started right here. Oh, it's been a movement that's been brewing in the earth. Over 2 years ago, in my prayer room, there were two little girls, one front row right here, one was up here singing. It was in the middle of a pandemic, and I was just drawing near to the Lord in the dark. Some of y'all think that what you're doing in the dark is not seen. In the dark, nobody saw it on social media. I didn't post about it. I lived it. I woke up every morning to seek his face because I understand it is my oxygen. Two little girls said to me, Mama, do you mind if I join you in that place so I can learn what you do to connect with the Lord? I said, you might as well now. If you say you want to go, we're going to go. Those two little girls, they started joining me at 6 a.m. in my prayer room. And what started off is just a little thing that I was doing with girls that I walked out life with. God began to whisper, it's not just for them. Started sharing their testimonies and all this stuff that they were learning in the Word. And I'm telling you, they were thirsty and hungry and finding new revelation because so many people have told us that we need to be women of fasting, women of prayer, but they'll never show you how. I said, I'll be the one. If I have to lock arms with other women to show them how, I will show them how to call on the name of Jesus and get answers. Oh, it only took a few. We went from this to a beta group. If any of my beta group permission room women are in the room, can you join me up here? I want y'all to see that I ain't just talking about it. We've lived this thing for almost 2 years. After the beta group, I got a little more crazy because y'all know it's only crazy till it happens. I said, God, if you can do it in them, maybe if I open this thing up to the whole wide world, maybe you'll send some women that have been looking for a voice that will cry out and spare not. And what happened amazed me. All other permission room alumni, join me at the front of this stage. Coaches, can you turn around and grab these bundles of roses? As they come up here, can you start giving them to them? This is impact. This is impact. As they're coming, it got so big that we said we needed to open up something bigger. If there's a permission wall, women, any permission wall, women, join me up front. Y'all, this is a real thing. I actually know these women by name. Jennifer Etheridge right there. And then there, she's from here. But then there's a girl named Sedalia all the way from Canada. I saw Nakia Sankey. Where you at? Wave your hand. That's another one right there. I call her my Alabama girl because she talked like she's from Alabama. I never met her until Thursday. A small yes. A small yes. That's Yasmin right there. She's all the way from Jersey. That's Thais right there. She's all the way from Jersey. That's Maria White right there. That's Naja, who decided that she couldn't exist far away from the fire. She moved to Columbia, South Carolina. That's Helen July right there. That's Crystal Mosley and Keontra. He knows them by name. I can tell you something even more beautiful. Although there's a lot of women at the front of this stage, like Charmaine and Deja, Nee, Santana, Vera, Kim, Chelsea, who called on me before I even knew I had anything to give. There are Christies and Liz Marys, my God, Whitney Miller. She was driving in the car when she put her application in. I remember, and I'm invested like that. What I understand is, and I tell these women all the time, I can't carry this alone. Micah, I tell them all the time that free women. I didn't just start pouring my life into you for you to sit on what he poured. You must duplicate yourself. And I tell you that I'm not telling you something that I'm not willing to live. Even as we stand with all these women, back in 2019, I thought that I was just obeying the Lord. And I actually, if I'm honest, I didn't even say it, didn't even think about it until this moment. I actually thought I failed when I gave him this yes. In 2019, God asked me, and with the pushing of my sister Keisha, he asked me to write a book of my actual story. I called it Permission. We self-published it. I've never been a writer. I thought I would be a writer. I'm a country girl from Georgia. I penned this book. I'm real pregnant at the time when we launched it. And I was like, Lord, I gave you something that was incomplete. Let me tell you what he says back. You obey, and inside of obedience is everything you need. What I didn't know was that at 2023 conference, God would make way, and he wouldn't just let it stay a self-published book. He would get that book somehow to the hands of an editor, or you know, one of those people that seek out people that ain't looking to be sought out. This lady finds me, and she says, I just don't believe that this can exist with just a small group of ladies. She called this small. She said that this right here is just a seed. She said, we're going to take that book that was self-published that you hand in obedience. We're going to bless it, break it, multiply it. And all the world is going to hear all around the world what it looks like to have the permission to live free. That book will launch next year this time. We have a national publication. It won't just be my story, it'll be our story. They're giving me the opportunity to add more chapters and refine a thing that I gave in obedience. You might think in this moment, this is just to commemorate what they've already done. It is not. It is an invitation for you to join us. Ladies, what I want you to do is, y'all know we give to give, right? So this flower that you received, go find a woman in this room, and you should have received a gift when you walked in. You may not have known what it was. There's a QR code. I want be one that joins the permission world. We're giving you access to something that doesn't have to stop right here. All you have to do is scan this code, 2 months free, to be a part of something that is bigger than yourself, to share your story that other women might be freed by it. I want to speak to my pastor wives and all those that feel like they don't have someone else that they can lean on. It's for you too. It's not just for your flock. It's for you too. I've even been dreaming about us doing permission rooms just for pastors' wives, these specific group of women, because we need someone to hear our voice. As they're passing those out, can we just allow the song of the Lord to just play over us? This is a banner of freedom. You have an opportunity to respond. Don't let this just be something that you were given access to that you don't take advantage of. I don't believe that your spirit man can make it without joining with other women that speak your language. What a moment he's brought us to. As they continue to pass out those flowers, let's prepare our hearts to get ready to worship.
Made in the image of Abba, I am free, completely safe in the arms of my Father. I am royalty. I am who you call me. I believe I am yours. Oh, yes, I am. Feel fully, wonderfully. Completely safe in the arms of my Father. I am the blood in the hand. masterpiece. I thought before life ever started, you took your time on me like.
Back in May, it was May 21st. I believe on the side of a mountain in Cabo, Mexico, that hell had an opportunity to peek in on what heaven was preparing. He said, I believe there's a little girl from Sandersville, Georgia, that's getting a little more crazy with her faith. One that said, I ain't never scared of no devil. Do I got any knock if you bug and raise the hallelujahs in here? Oh, I got a little thug in me too, and I wish the devil would. I ain't scared of you. Because the God of angels' armies, he fight for me. Somebody make a sound to let heaven know. No more backing down. We settle for fear and shame long enough. The word of God says, if my people who are called by my name. Oh, he got a strong name. He got a little more to it. He said you can't just call his name in public. He said if you would humble yourself and pray and seek my face, and it get a little more dangerous, if you would turn from your wicked ways, he says, then will I hear from heaven and I'll heal the land. Do I got any praying women in the room? Oh, I can see clearly now that the rain is gone. I see my daddy standing up big in me. I was on that mountain in Cabo, Mexico, celebrating one of my husband's best friend's birthday. And the devil had the audacity. I believe he's been getting audacity with you. And I just tell you what, I got a righteous indignation rising in me. I'm sick of the devil. I'm sick of his schemes. I'm sick of his fiery darts. I'm sick of his tactics. All those other way voices saying you are not enough, that you lack, that you need to add more. I was on that mountain and he tried to take a life that didn't belong to him, Bree. I don't belong to him. I have a daddy. His name is Jesus. You have a father in heaven and he fights for you. Jehovah Sabaoth, the Lord of Lords, he will take care of you in the middle of a weapon forming. That's why he says in his word, that weapon might form. Has anybody seen some weapons forming? I got news for some women in here. He might form those weapons, but those weapons will not prosper. Can you shout at me? Say, long live the queen. Y'all didn't say it like you believe there's some queens in here rising. Say, long live the queen. I didn't say, long live some scared girl. I didn't say, long live some hesitating woman. I didn't say, long live some side chick. Enough is enough. I believe that the God is calling on the remnant to rise back up and take your place. If you believe you're a queen in this room, shout back at me, long live. Long live the queen. Did you know that he came that you might have life? I ain't talking about some raggedy, broke down, barely making it kind of life. He said that he came that you might have life and life to the full. Anybody want abundant life in here? Is there anybody willing to do what it takes to experience that abundant life? If it means rising early, will you rise? If it means cutting off that bull, will you rise? If it means walking away from that job, will you rise? I asked the Lord, I said, Daddy, you asked me to give this clarion call for the inside out life. This life that was not all about the outside. Or we do looking good well. But I said, God, you know I'm one of those girls that got questions. Let me tell you what they used to call me in 2017. I got a new name now. I'll tell you about it later. 2017, I was at a conference just like this. And I was hungry and I was desperate. Lauren, I didn't really understand why I could see all of this in my dream, but I had not actualized on it, sis. This prophet came to me, sis. He said, you, my daughter, you suffer from the paralysis of analysis. Always overthinking. Always wanting everything to look good. I got any recovering perfectionists in the room? Oh, you're going to be set free today. He sent the right one today. Yeah. I stand as chief recovering perfectionist. Oh, I wanted them T's crossed and I wanted them dies dotted. I said, yeah. T's crossed, I's dotted. Even in the middle of imperfection, he is the God of perfection. I don't need to be right anymore because he is. Anybody know you serve a God that is already perfect in all of his way? My God. Y'all, I'm going to try to read this text real quick because we are going somewhere. If you have a Bible, grab your Bible. If you don't have one, follow along with me. I believe that the King of Glory has something to say. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Daddy, you promised. You told me that if I did my part, that you do yours. You have astounded me. I pray, Father, that as my husband said, as they see me set myself on fire and burn, that this fire would be contagious. That it will burn up everything that is not like you. Every unclean thing. Every doubting thing. You'll do better to doubt your doubts than to doubt the Father. Speak, Holy Spirit. Because I believe that there are some queens that are ready to hold their crowns back up. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Let's turn to the book of Esther, chapter 2. Esther, chapter 2, verse 5. The Bible says, at that time, there was a Jewish man in the fortress of Susa whose name was Mordecai, son of Jair. He was from the tribe of Benjamin and was a descendant of Kish and Shimei. His family had been among those with King Jehoiakim of Judah. They had been exiled from Jerusalem to Babylon by King Nebuchadnezzar. This man had a very beautiful and lovely young cousin, Hadassah. Yeah, Hadassah. Y'all heard about miracles called Hadassah, who was also called Esther. When her father and mother died, Mordecai adopted her into his family and raised her as his own daughter. Reminds me of a Mordecai in my life called Pastor Matthew. That when he saw an orphan girl, he said, this one right here needs to be fathered. We're going to jump over to chapter 4. Verse 5, Esther, and I'll fill in all the blanks as we go. She starts having a conversation with this uncle called Mordecai that is a type and shadow for our Abba Father in the midst of this text. Chapter 4, verse 5 says, then Esther sent Hatak, one of the king's eunuchs who had been appointed as her attendant. She ordered him to go to Mordecai and find out what was troubling him and why was he in mourning. Hatak went to Mordecai in the square in front of the palace gate. Mordecai told him the whole story, including the exact amount of money Haman had promised to pay into a royal treasury for the destruction of the Jews. I want you to tell somebody there's a death threat out for the remnant. Mordecai gave Hatak a copy of the decree issued in Susa that called for the death of all Jews. He asked Hatak to show Esther and explain the situation to her. He also asked Hatak to direct her to go to the king to beg for mercy and plead for her people. So Hatak returned to Esther with Mordecai's message. Then Esther told Hatak, hey, go back and tell this message to Mordecai. We're in verse 11. She says, all the king's officials and even the people in the province know that anyone who appears before the king in his inner court without being invited is doomed to die unless the king holds out his gold and scepter. And the king has not called for me to come to him for 30 days. Hatak gave Esther's message to Mordecai, but Mordecai has some more to say back. He had some more to say back to her questions. Mordecai said this reply to Esther. Don't think for a moment. I pray somebody hear me in here. Don't think for a moment that because you're in the palace, you will escape when all of the Jews are killed. If you keep quiet at a time like this, oh, I believe he's talking to some women in this room. If you keep quiet at a time like this, Dale, Mima, if you keep quiet at a time like this, he says, deliverance and relief for the Jews will arise from some other place, but you and your relatives will die. Who knows? Who knows? If perhaps you were made queen for just such a time as this. Who knows if perhaps you're just at permission conference for such a time as this. Esther responds. Then Esther sends this reply to Mordecai. She says, go. Gather together all the Jews of Susa and fast for me. Sound like a girl named Jackie that called together them permission women. And she said, I don't want a trip. I want an outpouring. And if we have to push back our plates, if we have to open the doors wider than we ever opened them, we'll do what he said. Do not eat or drink for 3 days, night or day. My maids and I will do the same. I'm talking about women that walk it like they talk it. And then though it is against the law, I will go in to see the king. Anybody know what it's like to go in to see the king as an intercessor on behalf of his people? If I must die, I must die. So Mordecai went away and did everything as Esther had ordered. I want you to tell one more person before you sit down. Long live the queen. One thing that the Lord has challenged me as I hold this banner of freedom up is not to just tell one chapter of my story, but give it to you in fullness. I've been asking the Lord ever since he started whispering about this conference, Lord, what do you want me to talk to them about? What do you want me to say? He said, Jackie, you are a message. You yourself are the word in flesh, made in my image and in my likeness. But with all my image bearing, somehow God decided that although he was going to put hidden treasure in me, he was going to wrap me and women like you in valuable, frail, dusty creations. If I had to be honest, there are moments that this dust creation starts messing with what's on the inside of me. I've heard the word of the Lord. Jackie, Permission Conference 2022. We have given the invitation to all these women to come and speak and sing prophetic sounds in this room. And I recall about 4 days ago, standing in the back of this building, as I'm believing God to sell this place out, and look at it, sold out. As I am calling other women into freedom, I find myself grappling with my humanity. I had an incredible brother of mine. We had a conversation. Anybody collect cups? You know, you got these mugs that look real cute. They got little sayings on them. Y'all, I got any tea drinkers, coffee drinkers? You know, you get all these cute little sayings and they look different, say a lot of different stuff. Some of them real cute, real pretty, real petite. I was in the back with Pastor Matt, and it's something about having the right people in your corner. They'll remind you of who you are sometimes when you forget. I got any women in the room that just have moments where you might doubt what the Father said about you? Oh, don't act like, I'm only going to talk to real women. Do I have any women in the room that sometimes you might rock yourself to sleep crying because you're not sure if you can do the thing you heard him say? I was standing in that back hall as we are preparing this place and we're strategizing. And I said, Pastor Matt, sometimes, although I know what I heard him say, I just feel like it's not enough. I got any women ever struggle with inadequacy? Like, Lid, I know you called me to be intercessor. I know we say stuff in permission world. Like, I got any baddies out there, some bold, anointed, and destined women in this room? We know in moments who we are. But sometimes, although there are pretty things on the outside, we want things that are pretty and lovely more than we want things that have capacity. My sister was prophetically singing, "Fill My Cup." I said, oh, Daddy, you all up in here. Fill me up. Fill my cup. You see, what I don't want to call a cup, but a vessel. And I was struggling. I said, Pastor Matt, sometimes I just feel like my cup looks too ordinary. It ain't nothing wrote on it. They don't have a specific name to call me. I can call out things, and all these women, like, I can tell you who you are. You're a strategist. You are a musician. You're an anointed pastor. But sometimes I just feel like I'm ordinary in everything that I do. Just plain. Pastor Matt said something to me, y'all, that blessed my life. He said, you know, sis, I don't quite see your cup the same way you do. Because there are moments when I've looked at my cup that man has wrote on. And they've labeled me musician. And the words that they labeled with me limited me. I like your cup, Pastor Jackie, because I don't see a specific label on it. I know you've been through some stuff, but I don't see any limitation to what God has said you can do. You might look ordinary to the blinded eye, but anybody that can see in the spirit, I believe that they will see a vessel of honor. Can I tell you what a vessel is? It is a carrier of the glory. It is a thing that sets itself posture at the feet of the Lord that says, I might not have it, but I believe you do. This might look ordinary on the outside, but within this cup, there's an extraordinary God that is unlimited, full, abundant, And there's something that's crazy that happened when you let a vessel of honor open the door for people to see. What comes out of things that look ordinary. I want some women that have been doubting that ordinary wasn't enough to get up in here and give the God that is extraordinary on the inside of you a praise. You don't have to have it. You don't have to have it. In your lack, there is fullness. He says, in your weakness, I am made perfect. These self-made labels, they might call you blessed, but they don't know you're wealthy too. They might call you single, but they don't know you carry it. They might see rejected, but I'm telling you, I dealt with rejection. I dealt with fear. I dealt with inadequacy. But on the outside, when you let the King of Glory get a hold of your cup and you let him shed his marvelous blood all over you, things that used to be on the outside can't be seen anymore. You don't look like what you've been through. Do I got any women with a testimony in here? I might be from a small town, but my anointing is not small. I might have been rejected, but he calls me chosen. I might have been broken, but I serve a God that'll put me back together. Somebody give it up for a God that made a way for you. Ordinary women that serve an extraordinary God. And here comes Queen Esther. She is a Jewish refugee in a foreign, hostile land. Found herself in unthinkable situations and circumstances. She didn't expect that her mother and daddy would die. I didn't expect my mother not to be present in this room. But a God that is sovereign. We spoke about it, Alpha and Omega. He will stand in the middle and he says, I'll be a mother to the motherless. I'll be a father to the fatherless. This Queen Esther, at her beginning, she just looks like an ordinary cup. Broken, rejected in a hostile land. She looks like she doesn't have anything to give. Sounds like a girl I know. I thought there was no way he could use my ordinary self. Queen Esther. She was from a broken place, a place that looked like there was no way she could reign, but God saw more. Can I just tell you in this room that God has eyes to see you? He has eyes to see you. And he is calling you forward tonight. This woman that looks like there's no way she could be what God is preparing her for. She steps on the stage of this biblical text and she's being prepared for the right place at the right time, for the right thing to happen. I believe that I have some women in this room at the right place. You might not believe it. If you don't believe it, sit right there. I believe that I got some women at the right place, at the right time, for the right queen to rise. I believe it. I believe it. I believe it. We had our brother Ty Tribbett here this past Sunday, and he was like, what are you most excited for this weekend? You won't believe what I told him. I said, I'm excited that I really believe the Lord now. No outcome, just faith. I believe that he can do with me whatever he desires. I believe that he'll take my ordinary self and do something extraordinary, just like he is doing in you. The Bible says at the top of this text, this man had a very beautiful and lovely young cousin, Hadassah, who was also called Esther. Did you know that sometimes the world may call you something that is not actually your name? They might call you the rejected one. They might call you the nasty one. They might call you the one that is not able to do the thing that the Father has said. He said, girl, they might call you Esther, but you Hadassah. And don't ever forget it. Do y'all mind if I tell you what Hadassah means? Hadassah means myrtle. Myrtle. It's a tree. They talk about it in Isaiah 41. We could throw that passage up. Isaiah 41, verse 19. I want to tell you what the Bible says. It says, I will plant trees in barren deserts. Cedars. Kevin, what you told me that next A word was called? Acai. Myrtle. Olive. Cypress. Fir. And pine. I am doing this so all who see this miracle will understand what it means, that it is the Lord who has done this. The Holy One of Israel who created it. He has created this woman that is called to stand up in a foreign, barren land. Sounds like some girls in 2022. Where we are hearing about wars and rumors of wars. We are hearing about breakouts and breakdowns and all manner of evil. And I believe that he's called some Hadassahs to rise up. There are some myrtles in this room. Some women that are called to bring forth fruit in barren lands. Will you, even though they call you Esther, this is what my sister was talking about. Esther actually means star. And sometimes, sis, they get it confused and they think you're the star. That's Hadassah you see, girl. Oh, you think I'm shining because you call me Esther? No, ma'am. It's Hadassah speaking up in me. From the very beginning, before he formed me in my mother's womb, he knew me. Chose me, set me apart, and said, girl, you are going in time into the earth to be a myrtle in a barren land. I believe that the Lord has sent me on assignment as a Hadassah to this generation of women that are ready to rise up and stand as a remnant you've been called to be. If you are another Hadassah in this room, sound like it. I ain't gonna pump you or prime you, because Hadassah, she don't need no pumping and priming. She's been too much. She's been through too much not to give him all the glory. She stood through unthinkable things. And somehow, he keep on making ways out of no way. Somehow, he does it over and over and over again. He takes my little and he says, girl, that's enough. You got two fish and five loaves, I'll take that. You got one little yes, I'll take that. You got some shame you want to give? I'll take that. You got some bitterness you want to give up? I'll take that. I'll do in you what you've been trying for people to see outside of you. This little cup, so pretty, but so limited. It looks gorgeous on the outside. And I'm afraid many of our families, Michelle, They want us to settle for just being pretty and lovely when there's a deliverer on the inside of you. He says, beauty, it'll fade away. But his word that's on the inside, that Hadassah word, it'll last. It'll do what it was sent out to do. Don't settle for limited when you got capacity you can have. He'll write things on the inside of you like righteous because he's righteous. He'll write things like pure on the inside because he is holy. He'll write things on the inside of you like forgiven because he went to Calvary that you might own the right to be forgiven. This woman in this text was sent in time to save a generation. Her whole family, her whole nation was under the threat of annihilation. This man named Haman had rose up at that time to be a servant of the devil. Do y'all know that the devil will use anything? He'll use a mountain in Cabo. He'll use Bobo. He'll use your finances. He'll use that job. He'll use success. Oh, y'all ain't. Oh, I'll talk to these people over here. I believe that I got some witnesses that know he'll use whatever you let him. Hadassah, she enters this palace, goes through all this preparation, and they have to pour oil on her and all these perfumes on her to prepare her to walk in that which the Lord had created her for. Did anybody know that it takes preparation to walk in the call of a queen? Luke says it like this: it'd be better that you count the cost, Norman, before you step out saying that you're ready to be a queen. Because some people don't count the cost in. They get laughed at because when it gets hard and the winds and the waves start beating upon that house, they find out that they give up with only a foundation laid. I believe that I have some women in this room that said enough is enough and I'm not giving up anymore. Don't fool me. I got any women in the room that said I ain't never scared and I ain't going back. The cross before me and the world behind me. Anybody in the room that says, if I have to go by myself. If I have to go by myself, Denar. I remember being a college girl when everybody was dropping it like it was hot. I was down on my knees praying to Jesus. I said, God, I don't know what you're preparing me for, but whatever you're preparing me for, my answer will be yes. I need some women in this room to get a yes in your spirit, to get a yes in your mind, to get a yes in your marriage. I need some queens to rise with a yes on your tongue. Yes, yes. Yes, Lord. Yes. And my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. And my answer will be yes. Don't say it if you don't mean it. And my answer will be yes, Lord. She gets prepared, and there's something about when you agree to obey the Lord. I teach this word called only obedience. We wear ourselves out trying to do more than the Lord has asked, and we cause ourselves to be paralyzed by not doing all that he's asked. There's a place in the middle called only obedience. If I don't ask you to sacrifice him, don't sacrifice him. But if I say sacrifice him, go up on that mountain and say what I said. Do I got any Abrahams in this room? I believe that when he calls for a thing, that inside of that instruction is provision, is protection, is the way already being made. Esther is in a moment of only obedience. She, like many of us, we hear the Father call us into places and to spaces for such a time as this, but we have a whole lot to say back, sis. He says, hey, daughter, go into the king, open up your mouth and say what I said. And we say, daddy, you know that they'll kill me for that, right? You know they'll judge me for that, right? He says, all right. You cannot do what I say. And not only will people perish, you will perish. Some people are wondering why you are here but not alive. You wonder why you keep feeling these urges and these moanings and groanings on the inside of you. I just want to let you know that I stand as a Mordecai today. And I say to you, if you don't speak up at a time like this, just because you're in the palace and he done brought you out some stuff, and you think you all, you sophisticated and you all cleaned up, but you done forgot about when you used to be nasty and ratchet. That your cousin, she's still nasty and ratchet, and she need a free woman to go free her. Do you remember when it was you? We forget so easy. Oh, we put on our priestly collars and we walk around like royalty. Can I tell you that real queens, they give away crowns. Sis, they don't just look good. They don't just talk good. They say stuff like, if I gotta die, let me die. If I gotta fast, let me fast. If it's for my sister Rhonda, even though my life might be on the line, she's worth it. There are a whole bunch of Jewish Hadassahs in this room that I've declared, if I got to scream aloud and spare not in the kingdom, you don't have the right to remain silent. I know they say stuff down here contrary to up there. Your life is not your own. He says he doesn't pour out his spirit in things made by man. No, 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 no. He's looking for some women that are not self-made, but God-made. He's not looking for women bosses, but women daughters. He's saying, I'll take every part of your origin, every part of your pedigree, and I'll use it to save a generation. Do I got any generational curse breakers in this room? Kim, you went on behalf of all of them. And you said, as for me in my house. Does anybody got one of those in your spirit? Vera, as for me and my house. I wish a devil would. Crystal, enough is enough. Y'all know I got an apology for a lot of y'all. Many of y'all saw me in some seasons prior, and I gave you something that was real counterfeit. But let me tell you, this girl wants to give you a new introduction to who she really is. I'm ordinary to some, but I believe there's some women in this room that have eyes to see. There's extraordinary God on the inside of me. Long live the queen. What makes you a queen? Is it what you add to the outside? I thought queenship passed through legacy. I thought it came with a little responsibility, a little weight, sis. She talked about it. This weight of glory, I'm telling you, it's not made for man to carry. You better lay that thing back at his feet. Many of the reasons you're calling yourself anxious and depressed is because you're trying to carry and manage a weight that you were never married. You were never made to manage. Tonight, I'm speaking to every Hadassah in this room. I'm calling every queen in this room to come forward. If you're in this room and you believe that the Lord has set something down on the inside of you, that even in barren places, even in places that y'all come on up here, don't act like you didn't hear the call. He was talking to you. I believe that he's heard the cry of a generation. And there's some women that said, if the old me must die for the new one to live, kill me, Jesus. Take everything that I thought I was. Take everything that I am. My life belongs to you. I believe that you'll take something that's ordinary and you'll make it fit for a crown. Every woman in this room, I want you to look up at me. I want you to say this after me. I am a queen. I want you to say, I am free. Make a sound like you're free. Make a sound like you're free. Don't stop until he says so. Don't stop until he says so. You're just serving hell notice. You're just serving hell notice. You're just serving hell notice. Open up your mouth and let a devil know. Do some stuff, but I won't stop now. If I die, let me die. But I'll go. Jesus asked a question in the Bible as he's preparing to send some agents out. Who shall I send? Who will go for me? Do I have any women in this room that says, let it be me, God? No more why me, but let it be me. I've settled long enough. I've choked on my words long enough. I gave you a keychain that had a crown at the end of it because I pray that every time you see, you get a little bit louder. You get a little more crazy. You believe a little bit harder. We're not just a generation of pretty and lovely women. We are vessels of honor that set themselves in moments. And we understand that all it takes to be a queen is to open yourself up, God, and say, fill me up. Oh, fill the room, fill the room, fill the room. Feel the room. Feel the room. Feel the room. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Come on, fresh. Receive it.
Holy Spirit.
More power.
Holy Spirit.
Receive it. More fire. More courage.
Feel the room, feel the room. Holy
More strength.
Spirit.
New
Holy
joy.
Spirit.
Fresh oil.
Feel the room, feel the room.
Sing it like you mean
feel
it.
The room, feel
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Holy Spirit.
I ain't just talking to young women. There's some people that have been talking out of who they've been called to be. Jesus, come. Do what man cannot do. Do what man cannot do. Jesus, fill this room. This is a brand new start for you. This is a brand new yes for you. The Lord has been waiting on your yes. You've been drawing me the whole time. Look up right here at the front. You've been drawing me the whole time. The Lord has been waiting on your yes. It's not too late. It's not over. You are what He said you are. Can I tell you what my Mordecai told me? I had went to a church and I preached it. I didn't feel quite like I gave them real authenticity, and I was doubting and questioning again. My spiritual father, he said, Jackie, don't lose courage. Don't lose heart. You get back down there. You stay in the game, and you give him another yes. You might not have did it last year, but I declare by this time, next year, you won't even know who you are. Odessa, come forward. Before, and I didn't see any change. As He is inviting you to the throne of grace, He says, come boldly again. But this time when you come, come with the expectation. Come believing like a little child again. Come with new audacity. Because the beauty is, He didn't just tell her to come before the king and allow her to die. He let the old her die, but a new woman emerged. And not just a new woman, but that remnant, it was saved. There are women and a generation of Israelites still alive today because of queens like Hadassah. I believe there will be stories told about the yeses that were given in this room today. I believe that there will be children who will have different destinies because there were yeses given in this room today. Anybody want to cry out for your generation? Anybody want to cry out for that husband that ain't quite got it yet? Let me hear a woman of God travail the Father.
Oh, And the way I can typically tell if it's prophetic is if it's something I never heard before. And it's a very unique, specific word. How many armor bearers or pastor aides or number twos are here? Like, you're here and your primary responsibility is to assist the one. If that's you, can you lift your hand high? This word is for you. This word is for you. Because you're typically the one who's unseen. But you have a very special anointing. And I like to eat out occasionally, really only to my favorite Asian restaurant. But I have a habit of leaving a sizable tip. I just feel like it's a great way to just express the love of God to people. And as I was worshiping, the word of the Lord is this: He has a heart for the servers. And this was the phrase that he gave me. He said, "Tell my daughters that I'm sending help to the help."
Jesus.
Listen, that.
PJ.
Long live the queen.
Long live the queen. Where your crowns at? Yes. Drop them in the comment section below. Y'all, we love y'all so much. Don't forget to tune in to our new podcast,
Permission Talks.
Mm-hmm. Every other Monday, be tuned in. Dr. Jackie Green's YouTube page. Don't forget about Permission World.
And Permission Room.
And Permission Room.
Applications open this Friday.
Yep. So we love y'all. And we'll see y'all back tomorrow night for the last night. Yay.